guys, it's Kirti and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna be talking about the entire home buying process we've been through. It was so hectic, so intense and very overwhelming. However, once you get the house keys and once you move in, you forget everything. Before getting started, please subscribe to this channel and like this video. When you're buying a house, there are differences. Like, everyone's situation is so different from mine, but generally this should be the entire process, okay? Step number one, figuring out. Once you decide to buy a house, you definitely have this feeling that, okay, I don't know anything, I don't have anybody to tell me or guide me through how to buy a house and how much cash do I need. Obviously, we've been through, we spoke to a lot of our friends who already bought a house, yet we couldn't get so much clarity regarding, okay, how much approval will I get for the loan. We met a realtor through our friend's reference. She was really helpful. Basically, if you are going to meet a realtor, you do not have to pay any fee to them. Their services are totally free. Just talk to any realtor. They're gonna explain you every single thing based on your expectations, your preferences. So if you want, you are living anywhere in GTA or Durham region, you can contact our realtor. She helped us a lot throughout the home buying process and she is very straightforward and transparent. If you want, you can contact her. Details are in the description box below. You know, we booked an appointment with our realtor and we were still not so clear whether if we have to buy a house or not. We just didn't know anything, right? So she explained us everything. She explained us how much down payment we can do, the entire process basically. We gave our preferences. She went through a lot of filters, like how many bathrooms you are looking for, how many bedrooms you are looking for, you know, in which location you are looking for a house. We've let her know everything. Really, if you are in a confusion whether to buy a house or not, even after talking to a realtor, you can just let them know, okay, I might not be sure, but I just want to know the process. Doesn't matter, they're gonna still let you know the entire process. And it's a good thing if you are in a confusion, always talk to a real estate agent. Step number two is working with the realtor. So when you go to their office and when you meet them, they ask you for details. So what happened was, we've been put on a list and we have been receiving all the houses every single day that are for sale in the region. Our preference was Durham region. So any house that is registered under a seller, I mean under a real estate agent, before it hits the market, you will get a list. I think 24 hours or 48 hours before the house hits the market, everyone who is registered with a real estate agent will get a list of houses. We were asked to provide our bank statements, you know, our social insurance numbers, our IDs, our status like permanent residency, work permit, and we also provided her with our credit report. Credit score mainly. My credit score was 786, which was great. So we provided her with all the details. So she forwarded all the details to a mortgage broker of her own choice. She started working on our pre-approval process. Pre-approval process in the sense, so the bank is gonna let you know based on your income, how much loan can you get from the bank. So let's say your household income is $100,000, you might get approved up to $500,000, which is household income into 5 times. That is how much you can afford according to the bank. That is how much amount of loan they can give you. So let's say you are having $200,000 per annum income, you want a $1 million house, you can definitely go for a $1 million house, mostly because you are eligible to get that much loan from the bank. This is the general scenario and it totally depends on your case. I'm just telling you generally how it works, okay? The realtor will always work with your pre-approval. She's gonna get a mortgage broker for you. You do not have to do anything in the background. All you have to do is whatever documents your realtor is asking, just provide them and you do not have to worry about anything. You can just go through all the houses. Step number three, viewing houses. At least we were getting 10 to 20 houses in our list every day within our price range. So we let her know that the price range was 600k, but we always thought that, okay, we have to stay under 500k. We shortlisted few houses whichever we felt like these are good. Pictures are always deceiving. Few houses are so beautiful in person, when compared to pictures, and few houses are shit when compared to pictures you see. You always have to view the house before making a purchase. So we saw four houses at a time in Darham region. I think two of them were in Bowmanville and two of them were in Oshawa. The first house itself we saw, we bid for that, and the fourth house on the same day we bid for those two houses. Fourth house we saw, that was our first house we bid. It was listed for $500,000. So whatever the price you say on online, let's say you go to points2homes.com, you see houses for $400,000, $300,000. No, that's wrong. They wantedly list the price lower so that everybody, you know, gets attracted to that price, and everybody will come to that house to see, and they'll place their offers in order to increase the competition. This is what these real estate agents are doing. Such a beautiful house, we loved it. The best part is you can rent out the basement. The basement has separate entrance and it has its own kitchen, it has its own washroom, so it's called a legal basement. We couldn't get it in the first round during the bidding process, and they didn't even consider our offer. So we raised the bidding price, you know, like the offer. We bid it for 580 or something, and still we couldn't get it. Yeah, it felt so bad to get rejected from a house bidding. It just felt like getting rejected from an interview. So after that we felt really bad and we started looking for houses. But during the house viewing process, the first ever house we have seen was this one. It was listed for $425,000. It's a freehold, it's a semi-detached house. Renovated it very well and it looks so beautiful inside. Even though it was listed for $425,000, we bid it for $504,000. Later the seller told us that, okay, you have to raise your offers, this is not sufficient. We bid it for $554,000. Ridiculous, right? I know, more than $100,000 that was listed for, but still they didn't even consider our offer. I don't know how much that house was sold for, but it was ridiculously over asking, and they wantedly listed the price low, and we were in a competition with 29 other people who placed their offers on the same house. It felt so bad getting rejected again. See, we didn't see so many houses. We saw four houses. We bid on two houses. But you know, people generally say that, okay, you have to search for a house for 3 months. At least you have to at least look at 20-30 houses before you buy. It doesn't have to be like that. Sometimes even if you look at one house, if you like it, just go for it. After that, we saw another three houses. Those are not even houses, those are like, one of them is a condo apartment. So ridiculously overpriced, and it's not even worth it. I never liked apartments, honestly. Especially in Toronto, there are so many rules. If you have to live in an apartment, you can't bring all your friends home, you can't make noise, like you can't put higher volume. There are so many factors. It's my personal choice, okay? I would rather live in a basement than live in an apartment, because basement has a lot of freedom compared to an apartment. No offense, I'm not a fan of condo apartments. So next we saw two townhouses. One of them is this one. Step 4, securing a house. We bid for this house for $470,000. It was previously listed, I think, for $428,000. We really loved it, so we thought, like, let's go higher and just secure this house. In 24 hours of placing your house, you have to give them $10,000 draft. It just means that, hey, I'm serious about this home purchase, so let me give you a $10,000 draft. That's what it means. So we did that and we secured the house. After that, we got an inspection person, and just what that person does is just inspects the entire house. He let us know that, okay, the house is in a good condition. One, two repairs are there, which was a door. And so we let the seller know, hey, the door is not working, like the patio door. So the seller agreed to repair the door, and the door is now repaired. So if there are any repairs they have to do, this inspection person is gonna give you a report, and you have to let the seller know, hey, after the inspection, these are the flaws in your house, you have to get them repaired. Step 5 is the final stage. We were living in a basement for 3 years and we just want to buy a house and just move in. So we just let the seller know that, oh, okay, we want to move in within 30 days. If it's okay for the seller, they're gonna accept it. Otherwise, okay, if the seller says 3 months should be the minimum closing date, closing time. So yeah, you have to do 3 months closing time. So it depends on the seller totally. So after getting the mortgage approval and all the background work was done, we were asked to provide so many documents and we provided everything. We paid for the down payment we were given the keys of the house and it felt so good. It sounds so simple when I'm telling you guys, but it was so ridiculously intense. And there were so many sleepless nights during the home buying process. I couldn't sleep properly until I got the house keys. So I felt so happy when I got the house keys. And okay, let me give you a cost breakdown. The total cost of the house was $470,000. Interest rate was 2.1%. The mortgage is with CIBC Bank. It's a 25-year mortgage. So it's always advisable to get a 25. You know, the longer the mortgage is, it's good. I mean, if you can't afford to pay a lot of money up front, it is always good to get a long mortgage, because the longer you borrow, you can invest that money and get more than 2% returns. So yeah, at least if you invest in stock market, let's say for 25 years the same amount without paying for the house, even though you have the cash to pay for the house, you will get at least 10% returns for the next 25 years. The down payment was $50,000 including closing costs. It was approximately 8% of generally, if you are buying a home for the first time, you have to do at least 5% down payment, and you can do up to 20% down payment. That's the range. And this $50,000 includes lawyer fees, the draft we have given initially, the $10,000, it's including that. The closing costs, CMHC, mortgage insurance, and many others that are involved in the process. So that was our journey of buying the house. Before deciding to buy a house, these are the tips for you from my side. Ask yourself these questions. Number one, do you have a stable job so that you can pay your monthly mortgage? Second is, can you afford your mortgage payments every month? Even though if you lose your job, do you have any alternative? Or, you know, how can you afford, like, if you don't have a job, just in case? You have to think about that also. And number three is, do you have the down payment ready for your house? So if they say that 10% down payment, let's say $50,000 you have to do, it doesn't only cost you $50,000. You always have to have extra $10,000 to $15,000, because it involves a lot of costs, okay? You might end up paying a lot unexpectedly and spontaneously. So you always need extra cash, extra at least $15,000 you will have to have on the side. Number four, do you have any other debts? If the interest rate of your debt or your loan is only 2%, it's okay to have it, doesn't matter. But if you're having any debt for which you're paying more than 3.5% or 3%, it is highly advisable to pay it off first and later go with the home buying process. Because it is very important that you are not having any debts other than just the mortgage itself. So yeah, I hope you guys found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, let me know by commenting below this video. I will see you in my next video. Bye.